Welcome back, everybody. Now, in this particular video, we will see how to roll out the single sign-on for end users. Rolling out the single sign-on for an application is a six-step process. The first and foremost thing which you have to do is configure and test the single sign-on. You have to work with that vendor to configure this particular application and test the single sign-on. As you are going to change the authentication type for users, you have to plan the change cutover timelines. The timelines has to be defined. You also have to communicate with the users these particular timelines so that they get enough amount of time to understand how the change is going to happen. Another important thing, or the next important thing over here, is you have to train your support team. If the users are going to have issue, they will call support team. So support team have to be ramped up and provide the appropriate training for all these particular authentication changes. We also suggest that you should prepare an FAQs and provide that particular FAQs to your support team so that when they receive questions, they know the answers about it. At the final cutover, perform the testing with all your business users and with all your scenarios, which includes devices, users, network boundaries, etc. Once the integration test is successful, you can do the cutover and you can enable this particular SSO or single sign-on for all the users. Now we will see how the end users are going to use these applications. Our recommended way is using Access Panel. Access Panel is nothing but it's a one experience for the user where they can find all their apps and invoke the single sign-on for any app they want. Whether it will be a line of business application or it will be a SaaS application, they can still use that. We have provided a search ability where they can search the application and use that if the list is very big. Azure AD will not ask for authentication again for any app because users has already authenticated to log in into the Access Panel. User also can self-discover the apps by clicking on the Add App button. The Add App button provides a discoverability of the apps which organization has provided them so that they can request access and can use those apps. Now we will see how to use Access Panel for end user experience. The short URL for the Access Panel is myapps.microsoft.com, and with that, they can log in with your Azure Active Directory credentials and can see all the apps which have been assigned to use it. They can search any app which they want, or they can directly click on the app to invoke the single sign-on. Here, I'm going to invoke Salesforce as an application, and I can find that particular application to use. There is also an Add Application button. By clicking on the Add Application button, it gives the suggested applications. If there are no applications assigned, they don't see it. But if there are applications which have been given as a discovery for the users by an organization, they can see it over there. Now we will see how the service provider initiated or the app initiated single sign-on. In this process, the user actually directly goes to that application page and invokes the single sign-on. They might know about that URL or they might have bookmarked that application URL in their browser. We will see how this experience looks like for a user for Salesforce application. Now, a user types in the URL for Salesforce application, and we will see how they can invoke the single sign-on. Here in this screen, I have typed in my Salesforce instance URL for my organization. And now I do see this page for login. Here, I have an organization which is simply test Azure AD, and this login button appears over here. I don't see the normal username and password page. When I click on this particular page, user will be redirected to for Azure Active Directory authentication. And after the authentication, they can directly log in into Salesforce. They will not be prompted for any username and password if they have already logged in into any of the application which is enabled for single sign-on. If they have not logged in into any of the application, then Azure AD will prompt for authentication where they have to put their username and password, and after that they can log in. And this is how the experience looks like for a user, which is very streamlined and more secure for the organization. Thank you for watching this video.
Yeah, thanks for watching this video and listening to Jeevan and me. Hopefully this helps you guide you in how to set up single sign-on with Azure AD. For more information, visit the website in the banner below.